Sustainable use of natural resources is very crucial to the development of a country. Ethiopia is endowed with diverse natural resources. Among these, agricultural land and water are the most important resources. Sufficient food for domestic consumption and export can be produced if these resources are wisely and effectively used. Strong and sustainable economic development can also be achieved through sustainable use of natural resources. However, these natural resources are commonly not used effectively. To reverse the natural resource degradation, governmental and non-governmental organizations are aggressively engaged in soil and water conservation and related activities. Mattu Wereda, located in Oromia region, is one of the few places in Ethiopia with dense forest coverage. Data on the land use of Mattu Wereda has revealed that about 38% of the Wereda is covered with forest and 28% of the total land area is farmland. 72% of the Wereda have wet, temperate or Wainadega type of agroecology. The main rainy season is from April to October, and the average rainfall of the area is 1,836 millimeters. Agriculture is the main source of livelihood, and mixed farming is the main economic activity. Wedji Integrated Wetland and Watershed Project is one of the integrated soil and water conservation projects implemented in Mattu Wereda. The project area is located 9 kilometers northwest of Mattu town, the capital of the Wereda. Wedji Integrated Wetland and Watershed Project is targeting to benefit 5 rural qabeles of the Wereda. The project started in 2005, encompassing an area of 2,800 hectares. Total project beneficiaries are 1,688, of which 1,547 are male and 141 are female. Coffee is widely grown and its production is practiced in combination with forest development. On the other hand, the new settlement program, population pressure and agricultural malpractices have caused the flora and fauna to be endangered. In response to the problem, Ethio Wetland and Natural Resource Management with its partners has come up with the initiative of saving the Wedji wetlands and launched its pilot project. The project has been implemented with the funds secured from Swedish International Development Agency, or SIDA, via Sustainable Land Use Forum or SLUF.
Wedji Integrated Watershed and Wetland Project has been launched in collaboration with the Mattu Wereda Agricultural and Rural Development Office. The community and other governmental organizations have also been actively involved. Natural resource degradation and their causes were identified, and discussions were held on what measures to take to solve the problems. Since the project area is closer to town, it was also envisaged to be a demonstration site. It is with this objective that the project came into being in 2005.
Depending on the given circumstance, diverse natural resource management and conservation systems can exist. To this end, terraces of different kinds can be constructed to protect the soil from erosion. Due to mismanagement of natural resources, Wedji watershed and wetland reached at the point when it no more has its natural beauty. Soil brought by heavy floods from highlands has left its deposits on the wetlands and has contributed for drying of the natural vegetation. This in turn made agricultural operations very difficult and resulted in subsequent yield reduction. It has also shrunk the available grazing land and threatened animal and plant species. Significant endeavor has been made to rehabilitate and bring this wetland to its natural state. In this regard, planting of vetiver grass was one of the major important tasks accomplished. After 2.5 years of project implementation, communities of the area have acknowledged and appreciated vetiver grass for its effectiveness in conserving soil and water and for its economic significance. Mention for Mention was the pioneer NGO to introduce the vetiver grass to the area. Atot Alahon explains how vetiver grass was introduced to the area.
Vetiver grass is introduced to the area in 1997, and at the beginning, farmers were resistant to readily accept the grass. It is after recognizing its diverse economic and social benefits that they began to produce vetiver. A study conducted by Zen revealed that 70% of the houses were constructed from grasses grown on wetlands.
Planting trees in farmlands is done along contours following the lower edges or fania dew terraces built on farmers' plots of farmland. This makes vetiver very effective in sustainably conserving the soil and decreasing runoff. It has also protected grazing lands from further erosion. Moreover, the grass has multifaceted advantage for thatching and animal feed, among others. Dried vetiver grass is also used for making local mattress, pillow, and making the roof of traditional grain storages. Social benefit of vetiver grass is also very enormous, especially in time of mourning and traditional ceremonies. The project has aggressively engaged in multiplying and distributing of vetiver grass to the beneficiary community. Atot Alahun has the following to say on the distribution of planting materials to the farmers.
Vetiver multiplication is conducted on nursery sets obtained from the Wereda Agricultural Office. The technical work is done by the government development agents, while the project is providing the financial support. It is possible to multiply on farmers' field, but it is difficult to get sufficient tillers. So we insisted on multiplying them in government nurseries. Vetiver multiplication starts at the nursery with well-prepared soil and by mixing it with coffee pulp. Then bare tillers will be planted at a space of 40 cm. The space between rows is also 40 cm. The very distinctive character of vetiver grass is that if watered twice a week, supplied with compost, and if it is regularly weeded, cultivated and pruned, it will perform very well. No shade is required. If an individual is given with 10 clumps, it means he gets about 200 to 1000 tillers for planting.
Planting of vetiver grass is not like that of fruits and vegetables. The latter has short process and is simple. On average, multiplication of vetiver will take 10 months. 100 to 150 clumps of vetiver are needed to plant a length of 1 kilometer. Farmers will calculate on the amount of clumps to plant on their fields. The project is distributing planting material after the start of rainy season and farmers have finished cropping. From June 15 to July 15 is the recommended planting time. It's multiplied on the nursery. 10 to 15 will be planted in the same hole. Within 10 months of time, a single tiller alone can be reproduced into 10 other single tillers. It is with calculation that farmers are using the planting materials in their fields. During transporting, the seedling needs sufficient moisture. Soaking the roots in water for a few days would have been a preferred practice as it would improve the survival rates. It was, however, reported that the area has a heavy rainfall, thus there is no need of soaking the roots in water. However, it should only be kept under a shade. The tillers can establish within 7 to 15 days of planting. This shows that the climate is very suitable to vetiver production. Planting is done along contours following the lower edges of fania dew terraces, built on farmers' plots of farmland, and along waterways, disposing of excess rainwater to natural waterways. Planting is done at a depth of 15 cm and the space between the plants is 5 to 10 cm. That is to ensure that the clumps close the spaces between them completely as they grow horizontally. Farmers are responsible in controlling weeds and protecting the plants from animals. The community has adopted a traditional rule for penalizing farmers who let their cattle graze on the young seedlings. Farmers' training on natural resource management is the other major task carried out to benefit the target communities. Thus, farmers, development agents and agricultural experts, women and the youth have received training on vetiver care and production. Mohammed Daoud is an inhabitant of Adele Bisek Abele Peasant Association. He explains the benefits of the project.
Before we started planting, the project has given us a five-day training. With vetiver grass, I have constructed the roofs of a house and grain storage. I have also a plan to make a mattress. This land was not productive. However, since the past 2 years, the yield has increased. Before the introduction of the grass, we used to burn the soil to improve its productivity. We were not taking care of the land as much as we do these days.
Atoch Anita Desa is the other project beneficiary. He says the vetiver production has helped him to use his plots sustainably and for other additional purposes.
I have used the grass for covering the roof of the grain storage. Other type of wetland grass cannot stay even for 2 years. However, vetiver can serve for more than 3 years with no problem. I sold one row of the grass with 50 birr. I know some people fully covered their house with vetiver. It is also highly demanded during mourning and traditional ceremonies. I have been also using a mattress prepared from it for the past 4 years.
In the project area, including Eddir or local informational traditional community-based organizations, there are diverse social institutions actively engaged in natural resource management. Qabale and Wareda Agricultural and Rural Development Offices are conducting project monitoring and evaluation on a regular basis. Other non-governmental organizations are also playing an active role in the project. Atolema Jambare is the chairman of Adele Bisek Abele. He says farmers have a rich experience of sharing knowledge among each other.
Other people and myself have started to work after taking a training. We have started drinking clean water from hand-dug wells. 2 years after it was planted, I'm always advising and teaching the community to construct terraces and plant vetiver grass and tree seedlings.
In the past 2 years, the Sor Vetiver Multiplication Nursery site has been supplying planting materials to the farmers. Here, the seedlings stay for 10 months. There is 40 cm space in between seedlings that are 3 months old. Coffee pulp is widely used as natural fertilizer and water is supplied by gravitational force. Frequent weeding and cutting of the grass from its top is needed. Top cutting initiates for more tillers to emerge and triggers horizontal expansion. It is possible to have 10 to 15 different stumps from a given vetiver stump. Ato Talahun explains the process.
This is a tiller. 5 to 10 of this type of tiller is planted on farmer's field. We plant 5 to 10 of it together so that it can multiply very quickly.
The Wudji Integrated Watershed and Waterland Project has designed a strategy benefiting the youth and women. Women and the youth are actively engaged in vegetable production. Distribution of fuel wood saving stoves has also contributed a lot in decreasing the rate of deforestation. Wezero Aster Bakala is beneficiary of vegetable production scheme. Before the project, we were growing only beetroot and it was confined to backyard production. Now we are using the land effectively and produce carrot, cabbage and others. We have learned a lot. The vetiver grass has significantly contributed to the conservation of water and improved agricultural production. Wareda agricultural experts have estimated that in the past 2 years, agricultural production has boosted from 20 to 40% merely due to vetiver grass expansion. However, the sustainability of vetiver grass expansion and natural resource interventions is a big concern.
Farmers and development agents have benefited from the various trainings. Income generating activities have been identified and modern beehives and fruit and vegetable seedlings have been distributed. Which project is very effective in changing the life of the target population. Neighboring Kabales and Waradas have been very much impressed by the project results and are asking for similar undertaking. If it continues with the same momentum, it will be a promising project. The wetlands in the Warada have dried due to misuse of the resource. This project has performed a meaningful task benefiting both farmers and the Warada. Warada officials and senior Warada experts have given a capacity building training. There was no grazing land. Thanks for the project, now the area is covered with water and at times it is even difficult for cattle to pass. If the project has its own vehicle, it will surely perform better than it does now. Sometimes it is difficult to use Warada agricultural vehicle. But it is very good if the project has its own vehicle.
What are the benefits of the project to the beneficiary farmers? Ato Afwerk Hailu, Executive Director of Ethio Wetlands, has the following answer.
The project has accomplished more than 90% of its physical plan. All aspects of the project is very participatory. We believe nobody in the project intervention area is excluded from the project. Women and the youth are targeted and they are actively participating in the field works.
It is clear that an NGO works in a given area for a defined period. Then it will move to other places. Former project activities will either resume or weaken and be terminated. If the activity does not continue, it can be considered ineffective.
Neighboring Kabales and Waradas are desperately looking for the support of the project. It is true that the project will not continue indefinitely. Government offices have a great responsibility to make sure the continuation of the project. They even have to go to the extent of earmarking budgets.
I hope the project will be sustainable. The community is well aware that wetlands grass was abandoned and they have understood well the diverse advantages of planting vetiver grass.
Sustainability of the project cannot be realized solely with the effort of the project, but also with the joint efforts of the community, Warada Agricultural Office, Warada Administration, Kabale Social Institution or Adder, and the like. I strongly believe that this collaboration and effort will be a foundation for the sustainability of the project. In this regard, we are closely working with the Agricultural Office and the project plan is taken as part of the Warada plan. Due to this reason, I think the project will continue to be sustainable.
It is very evident that the efforts of Ethio Wetlands and Natural Resource Association in rehabilitating the Wadji Integrated Watershed and Wetland has registered remarkable results. Vetiver grass development, integrated with annual and perennial crops, and forestry development is an effective way of conserving soil and water, leading to improved crop yield. Due to vetiver production, water of wetlands have been conserved sustainably. Also, the biodiversity of the wetlands have been conserved. Other tangible social and economic the grass is well acknowledged. Local mattress, paper, oil, perfume, soap and pesticide are among other products produced by using vetiver as a raw material. In light of its versatile uses, promotion and expansion of vetiver grass to other parts of the project area and the country is indispensable.